respected Dr. S.C. Vats, Dr. Pandey, Dr. Gupta, senior members of the faculty, and the student body of the Vivekananda Institute of Professional Studies. Firstly, I want to congratulate Dr. Vats for naming his institute after the great Indian icon, cultural, philosophical, and religious leader, Swami Vivekananda ji. We have recently celebrated his birthday on the 12th of January, and I was mentioning to Dr. Vats and to Dr. Pandey and Dr. Gupta and others, my granddaughter was born 140 years exactly to the day after Swami Vivekananda. So it's the 12th of January 2003. Now, when you have an institute named after Swami Vivekananda, he is a perennial source of inspiration. And no student and no member of the faculty who is connected with this institute should at any point of their lives ever forget the fact that they belong to the legacy and the name of Swami Vivekananda ji. A person of superlative immersion in Indian culture, in Indian spirituality, his address at the World Council of Religions in Chicago in 1893 was an eye-opener for the entire world what India stands for. I have been Commerce Secretary and have traveled for 3.5 years to about 60 countries plus on government delegations. I accompanied Pranab Mukherjee when he was Commerce Minister to Russia. We had several meetings with the then Prime Minister of Russia, Mr. Chernomyrdin, at the White House in Moscow. I can tell you from global travels that I have had, there is no country in the world worth being born in as India. And anybody is so privileged to be born in this great country. We talk about United States, Germany, England. You can go and make money, hundreds of thousands of dollars, pounds, euros. They simply lack the spiritual vibration which this country has in every nook and corner. For Indians, the philosophy says dharma artha kaam moksha, based on a very moral life of principles of good conduct, carrying out your assigned roles and duties, you earn your livelihood, you fulfill legitimate desires, and ultimately strive for communion with the unifying divinity which underlies everything. When they say that the Indian religion, Hinduism, is polytheistic, it's a mistake. It's actually totally monotheistic. We believe in one supreme entity. But for the administration of creation, we have got so many deities and devis, devtas. But I'm saying this is a part of the urge in every single Indian born in this land. There is something beyond earning livelihoods and maintaining your families and living the life in the family and society. There's something beyond. We have to keep always that in mind. Primary purpose of human life is to use that for generating a very strong inward connection with the divine, which has sent us here for a limited time span. This is already predetermined. We came, and a time is already predetermined to the last second when one has to leave. Now the question is, in between, in that time span given to us, what are we going to be doing? Are we going to conduct ourselves in a manner which is adding happiness and value to our fellow human beings by acting out of love, compassion, goodness, or are we going to use the opportunity given to us, whether it is high office, it's a corporate leadership, some other kind of organizational and role model which you are assigned to discharge, will you use those positions in an exploitative manner, in a selfish manner? I was reading a book called The Meditations of Marcus Aurelius. He was a Roman emperor who lived in the 2nd century AD, 118 AD to 181 AD, 63 years he lived, Rome. He was a Stoic. Stoa was a wall somewhere in Rome where people with a philosophical bent of mind used to meet. And they started calling themselves Stoics. He writes in his book, the biggest duty of a human being is to use all God-given energies endowed by nature for the selfless service of fellow human beings. It's not saying that you shouldn't get a reasonable compensation, yes, but no exploitation. Why is it that India today is rated in the Transparency International rating as a country with a very poor record of public domain honesty? We have a very low rating. And the story is every time you go to government offices, grassroots level, whether it is a revenue office, police office, rationing office, education, wherever else, everything is, instead of rendering a very good, efficient, honest, courteous service, people want kickbacks. Why? What is this? This is not a part of dharma, it's not a part of hak halal ki kamai, pure income. In Gurbani also they say, hak paraya naan ka kya suar kya gai. For a Muslim, it is like having the meat of a pig, and for a Hindu, of a cow. My question is, I have asked this question at a national conference of all the Lok Ayuktas of the country presided by the then President Pranab Mukherjee Sahab at Vigyan Bhavan. I said, a country which prides itself that it is a dharma pradhan desh, sarva dharma samman desh, why is it that in such a country we need lokayuktas, we need CBI, vigilance, anti-corruption? Why? Aren't people motivated through their own value system autonomously to act correctly? Why should they be trying to put hands in other people's pockets to snatch something which doesn't belong to them? So this is a question people have to ask themselves. And we keep on saying, Mera Bharat Mahan. Mera Bharat Mahan apne lecture dene se nahi hoga. Mera Bharat Mahan hoga jab sabhi bharatiya apne sahi kartavyon ka ek pure sachai ke saath, sat nishtha ke saath uska palan karenge. Now the reason I am telling you this is because you have long life to live as all the students' community, by grace of God the faculty. There will be years and years ahead of you. And many times the questions will come up, you'll be faced. Do I breach the ethical code and start doing some things which are against the divine law? I can only assure you, for heaven's sake, may God be, God's blessings be on you, don't cross that double yellow line. If you cross it, there is going to be hell to pay. Because nature and the law of dharma, karma, that wheel chakra, karma chakra jo chalta hai na, it is unforgiving. Every religion says for every jot you'll have to give an account, why the bloody hell did you do this? That time if you say, oh, I made a mistake, sorry, you will have to suffer for it. And I have attended religious discourses, all these things. There is no balancing of books like an account book. Debit entry, credit entry, aapas mein balance ho gaya, net credit. in terms of action, reaction, karma and its result, there is no balancing. You do good, you get a good result. You do something wrong, you damn well have to face the consequence. Now, I have talked about this whole thing about commitment to professional excellence as a core issue I wanted to address today. Sooner or later, all of you, when you have passed out through this great institute, you will be taking on some role in the corporate world, maybe as a lawyer, as an IT expert, as a journalist. What I would like to say is, please keep your personal gyroscope compass right in front of you. Do only what you think is correct. And I used to tell these batches of new IAS officers, I was there in Rajnivas, 6 years and 3 months in my last tenure and earlier, the new batches of IAS, IPS who used to come to me for courtesy call, I would tell them, listen, you are starting your service. This job of IAS, IPS has not been given to you by any politician, any minister, any officer. It has been endowed on you by God Almighty based on whatever your karmic accounts are. Open your savings bank account only with the Almighty. Whatever you do, usko hazir nazir samajh ke, wo aapke us faisle se khush hone chahiye. No, humne kiya insaaf ke haq mein kiya. Sifarish ke basis pe nahi kiya. What do people do these days? Politicians say, ye kar do, ye mat karo. Ye theka de do, we'll get a nice kickback from the contractor. What the bloody hell is this? Ye mera Bharat mahan bana rahe hain, mera Bharat ko patan ki taraf le ja rahe hain. And in the organizations where you will be there, I have been also a director on the Tata boards in between my two terms as lieutenant governor. They have, you know, Tata has perhaps the best reputation of a corporate house for outstanding commitment to ethics and honesty. They say our principle is we will lose contracts, we will lose business, we will not violate the ethical code. So they deliberately ask if anybody has a doubt, should we do this, not do this, if you are on the borderline, kare na kare. They have a system of ethical mentors. So in the hierarchy, somebody is designated, he is your ethical mentor. If you have a doubt in your mind, go to him and ask him. And he will give you a guidance. A couple of years ago, at a cocktail reception, one person came up to me. We got introduced. I said, what are you doing? He says, we are doing some civil construction activity in the Baroda area, the Baroda, Gujarat. So there was an Ahmedabad-Baroda big flyover construction which was going on. He said, recently the Australian contractor, which was the main prime contractor for that flyover project, they had sent their quality control inspector to inspect the different sections which had been cast on the flyover. Now, he was a person from Punjab, and I know Punjabis like to always move very fast and also cut corners. When they carried out the analysis and the quality control evaluation of that concrete block that they had done, reinforced concrete, they found the cement was 3% less than requirement. 3%. The Australian prime contractor said to this fellow, break that whole slab, recast it 100%. He said, sir, it's only a matter of 3%. Please forgive this, and next time we'll make sure it's 100. He said, no. In quality, the tolerance is zero, finished. Likewise, when it comes to ethical standards, the tolerance level for violation is absolute zero. You do it, then you start the downward slide, and you never know when it will end. Couple of years ago, I was in a UPSC commission. They were having a committee. We went to the National Police Academy in Hyderabad. And we found a young IPS lady officer, assistant director of the academy. We were having an interaction with the faculty. So our group people asked that young lady, I said, why are you here in the training academy? You should be out in the field in a district administering the district police. She was from Maharashtra. She said, I was in the district police. I am from the UP cadre. I was posted out to a district, and a couple of months after my posting, I got a call from the chief minister's office. These three, four people are my political opponents in your area. Please prepare few criminal cases against them. Typical. She rang back after 1 week, sir, I have scrutinized all the police records. These fellows have done nothing which is, which makes them susceptible to be accused of any criminal activity. I am not in a position to carry out your order. 3 days later, transferred. Sent from one district to the other end of UP. Again posted there. After another 3-4 months, a further call came. आपके जिले में ये फलाने 3-4 हैं, इनके आप इनको जरा ठीक करना, केस दर्ज कर दो, ये कर दो. हर लेडी, सी दिस इज महाराष्ट्रियन गर्ल स्टैंडिंग ऑन हर ओन प्रिंसिपल्स. शी अगेन गेव ए कॉल बैक, दे हैव डन नथिंग रॉन्ग, नो केस इज मेड आउट. ट्रांसफर्ड. शी केम एंड मेट द चीफ सेक्रेटरी. सर, आई कैन नॉट वर्क अंडर दीज कंडीशंस. They are putting pressure on me, which I refuse to bow to. It's against the constitution and the law. Please transfer me for central assignment. Fortunately, her name was sent. Home Ministry sent her to the police academy. And another person who has spoken to me one-to-one, he was Director General of Police in Punjab. When I was Chief Secretary, he was Additional DG Intelligence. Outstanding work. When he became Director General, at some point there was a by-election to the Faridkot parliamentary seat. Chief Minister's son was standing as a Congress candidate. 14 days, 15 days before the poll, the Chief Minister said, "Lagda hai ke bahut zyada hawa jadi akaliyan de hak vich chal rahi hai." तो कुछ करो अपने थाने थूने दे बंदियां तो करो ताकि थोड़े जे वोट्स जड़े ना मेरे बेटे वालान. ही गेव अ पॉइंट ब्लैंक रिप्लाई. सर, माय ड्यूटी इज टू एंश्योर पीसफुल पोलिंग इन द एरिया. आई एम नॉट कंसर्न्ड विद द वोटिंग प्रेफरेंसेस ऑफ द पीपल. 14 डेज लेटर इलेक्शंस हेल्ड. द सन लॉस्ट द इलेक्शन एंड ही लॉस्ट हिज जॉब. He came and met me. Since we had known each other, I was Commerce Secretary at the time. I spoke to the people in Prime Minister's office. I said, he's a brilliant officer. He did very good work during those times. And please let him come and meet Prime Minister. He met the Prime Minister. Within 2 months of his being dismissed as Director General Police Punjab, he was made the Governor of Nagaland. As the governor of Nagaland, which was that time a lot of militancy, terrorist activity, attacks, he says, I went deep into the Naga areas, militant area, with just one jeep, my gunman sitting there, and one small escort vehicle. Otherwise, a lot of pilots and all that, police, military. He tells me himself, those people, they said, why are you here? He said, I want to have a cup of tea with your headman. They are very surprised. They went inside. Please come in. They offered him a cup of tea. He says they began to respect me so much that he is fearless. He has come into deep into our area, not bothered about his security and safety, out of his moral courage. Let us talk to him. And the whole peace in Nagaland today is because he worked out a standstill agreement while other issues are being, and the peace is maintained. He now lives in Gurgaon. What I'm trying to say is, you have to learn to stand your ground. And when you are in the corporate world or wherever else, if people tell you to do something which is improper, stand your ground. Ultimately, the strength is not coming from anybody, it's coming from God Almighty. While knock that door, we pray every morning, please give us your strength to do what is right. Why should you deal shabbily with your fellow citizens just because some person in political power has said, ki aise kar do, ye kar do. So don't deny anybody his due, or don't give anything which is uncalled for to a person who doesn't deserve it. So I have said that for good professionalism, three things are necessary. I have said it on many occasions. Number one is complete ethical and pecuniary, means in money terms, total integrity. Complete integrity. There's a salary that I receive legitimately. Nothing more than the salary will cross my door. Today, the story is the income tax department of the country. You ask people, are there, if you see, they say, vox populi. Awaza-e khalq nakara-e khuda. Awaza-e khalq, logon ki awaz, khuda ka nakara, it's like the trumpet of God. Ask people, is the income tax department honest? What is your general view? No. People are using all kinds of devices to collect money. Is the CBI very honest? CBI, if a person is out of favor, take up the case. If he has sorted it out with you, put the case in cold storage. Are desh aise chalega kya? Is the country going to be Mera Bharat Mahan by these kinds of behaviors? And who has to make up the mind? It's not, see, we are all individuals. Yes, we meet in groups, we share tea, coffee, spend time in canteens. But at the end of the day, please remember, it's a one-to-one between you and God Almighty. You are sent separately, will return separately. In the ICU, there is nobody. They are all outside. So what I'm trying to say is, for heaven's sake, going from institute, Vivekananda Institute of Professional Studies, make it a personal promise to yourself in face of God Almighty, I will stay as strong as Vivekananda was throughout his short life. But what a radiant example he left for us in India and for humanity. Never breach the personal ethical code. Second is, he must have very good domain knowledge. To be a good professional, you must have very good domain knowledge and continue to upgrade your knowledge. The knowledge frontier is expanding. Yesterday's knowledge is no longer adequate to deal with today. Where has IT gone now? Just see what transitions it has made. So you have to have continuous learning. Don't stop learning. And when I was coming here, they were saying, youth today are spending a lot of time on Facebook and Instagram and Twitter and all that bloody, all rubbish. Why are you networking your personal details to people who have no concern? Yes, your immediate family may be interested. You went on a holiday or you enjoyed a good restaurant. Putting out photographs, this, and wasting precious time which should be devoted to serious reading, serious discussion, and understanding of the world around you, and then making a positive contribution. Learning new things. Apart from reading your textbooks, there's a whole world outside. You are learning law, but there are so many subjects. There is history, science, space, there's that, everything, atomic energy. I'm saying, please have a very wide reading spectrum, interest. Niraj Chaudhary ji said in his books, India is most well endowed with intellectual abilities by God Almighty. He has given the finest brains to people in India. I know there are no foreigners here, so I am not offending anybody. But the reality is this. We have ability to see the big picture and the small picture, the micro and the macro. This is very unique. Some have a capacity for the macro, some for the micro, not both. And that is the reason why in microseconds, when a signal had to be sent by ISRO to Mangalyaan to fire some retro rockets, slow the rocket down so that it could be captured by the gravitational field of Mars. That was that precise. And in the very first attempt, Mangalyaan went into Martian orbit. This is the caliber of our Indian minds and Indian scientists. So with all these endowments, let us really try to serve Mother India in a very positive and meaningful manner. The third thing I have said is, one is complete integrity, second, very good domain knowledge and domain competence, and the third is an autonomous capacity for hard work. Once you know your responsibility, you stand and carry it out, whether it is 4 hours, 6 hours, 8 hours, you just stand and do it. Nobody has to remind you, this was due yesterday, why is it not here? This is prodding. There are some horses which keep on running themselves. Some need to be prodded. The third category need to be whipped. Why are we putting ourselves into lower categories? Stand up and work. Now, when we say developed countries, Germany, France, England, Canada, there when people are assigned a public responsibility, they stand and do their job. 8 to 5, whatever the time, they are standing. Our people, the moment somebody is not looking, I was living in Vinay Marg as a deputy secretary, Commerce Ministry 50 years ago. The chaps who were supposed to maintain the lawns, they were always found sleeping. Stairs ke paas aake niche, aram kar rahe hain. आराम क्यों कर रहे हो? अरे ड्यूटी का समय है. नहीं जी, बहुत थके हुए हैं. अरे काम नहीं हुआ तो थक कैसे गए? हमारे लोगों में थकने की आदत बहुत ज़्यादा है. और जब तक कोई प्रॉड ना करे, भाई तुम्हारे इट वॉज ड्यू यस्टरडे, व्हाई हैव यू नॉट डिलीवर्ड, दिस इज नॉट द साइन ऑफ ए गुड प्रोफेशनल. आई वॉज टोल्ड इन द अबाउट द पटना सेक्रेटेरिएट. Somebody had an appointment to meet the officer at perhaps 10 o'clock, 11 o'clock. He went there. So outside there was a sevadar sitting. He asked the sevadar, ji, mera appointment hai. Toh sahab aage hain. He says, haan ji, sahab aaye hain, par abhi susta rahe hain. Batao. He's come from a car. He has been driven to his office. Aur aake susta rahe hain, par kaam kya hoga? So please, autonomous. You should be able to stand up and do what you are meant to do out of your own sense of commitment. This is a duty assigned and I shall stand and do it. This is the difference between so-called developing and developed countries. Now I want to tell you two or three other things which are also in my mind important. If we say we are Indians, then our legacy of thousands of years requires that we have a very open mind to all diversities of faith and religion. Dr. Radhakrishnan wrote in the Hindu view of life, we are all brothers united in a common quest for God realization. The creed is not important to us. The quest, common quest to achieve higher realization, binds us as brothers and sisters. And by the way, God is nameless and timeless. We can choose to call him Ram, Krishna, Vaheguru, you know, Jesus Christ or whatever else, he is nameless and timeless. Anami Akal. Before he was being called Christ, he was still there, eternal. Before he was called Ramchandraji, I Satyug Treta Dwapar Bita. त्रेता युग में आए, द्वापर में कृष्ण जी आए, उससे पहले भी तो थे, परमात्मा तो थे वहां पे. लेट अस नॉट गेट इन टू दी सिली फाइट्स. समबडी सेइंग अल्लाह, रबुल आलमीन, दीज आर लैंग्वेजेस. रबुल आलमीन पूरे आलम का रब. वी स्टार्ट फाइटिंग. अच्छा वो मुसलमान हो गया बिकॉज ही इज सेइंग अल्लाह. तो बुल्ले शाह सूफी सेंट, ही सेट, लख इबादत करे जे कोई बने न कदे नमाजी, जब तक प्यार न होसी पल्ले रब न होसी राजी. एंड गुरु गोबिंद सिंह साहब, द फाउंडर ऑफ खालसा एंड आवर रिवर्ड गुरु, ही सेट, साच कहूँ सुन लियो सबे, जिन प्रेम कियो तिन ही प्रभ पायो. He is also talking about that. So fighting with each other on the ground, this is this and this is, you know, all religions have been welcomed here. The reason why the Jews are so happy with India is because India welcomed the Jews. No discrimination in history. When I was posted at the High Commission in London, there was a German Jewish couple who had escaped from Hitler. They showed me a book, History of the Jewish People. Opened a chapter, Jews in India. He said very proudly, we love your country because Jews never faced discrimination because they were calling God Yehovah. They call Yehovah. Theek? They have got synagogues in Cochin and those very old synagogues. We should never discriminate on grounds of religion. Number two, we have to show great respect to women, children, to all fellow human beings. And what we are seeing in terms of respect to women folk in public spaces in India is a matter of complete shame. This is not Mera Bharat Mahan. Ye Mere Bharat ko niche ki taraf le jaati hai, patan ki taraf. And everybody says ke jahan jis ghar mein Devi ki puja hoti hai, us ghar mein Lakshmi ka nivas hota hai. Puja means respect. And my mother used to tell me, please learn to respect small children. They are children in small. They have incarnated more recently, 3 years, 4 years, 5 years old. They are very old souls who are coming with their own sanskars into this Manushya Yoni. So respect for women and children. Now, when I was LG, I sent out a circular that every Delhi government school, 1100 of them, the boys in classes 8 to 12 will sign an annual certificate. I undertake to, throughout my life, respect women, protect them, do my best that I can, and never be a party to any kind of misconduct. It's an absolute must. And not only that you do it yourself, but make sure in your circle of colleagues, friends, that same value obtains. There is no compromise. The third is, of course, Dalai Lama Sahab said compassion. So for people lower down in the hierarchy, social hierarchy, economic hierarchy, acting out of compassion, sensitivity is required. They have no sifarish. No politician is giving a call, iska kaam kar do. They have no money bags to exchange for service that they are seeking. It is your duty to see that these people at the lowest rungs are given their just dues. And I used to, when I was chief secretary in Punjab, we were going through, KPS Gill Sahab also was Director General of Police at that time. We were addressing meetings in district, Punjab was disturbed. But I used to tell deputy commissioners, If anybody crosses your door and comes to your court or your room, the chair that is lying here is his right to sit on. You don't have to offer it to him. This is afforded by the taxpayers of Punjab. These chairs belong to them. They have a right to sit. And it is your duty to listen to them with respect, with care and sensitivity, and see what you can do to help them. We have to have this attitude. What do? We please our superiors, even in corporates, please the superior and act like a dictator on the subordinate. What is this? Where is the human touch? Every person should be given due respect and regard. And I used to tell the SPs of the city, call the constable who is on patrol duty. Call him for a cup of tea and talk to him for half an hour. He will tell you the ground reality in the city better than any DSP, any SP, any other officer will tell you. He is on the ground. Learn to listen to these people. Treat them with respect. So what I want to say is, these days, you know, and I've said it openly in such venues before, family solidarity is a very core value in India. Indian families have to stand as very solid pieces of the social brickwork. How can we build up good family relationships? By sharing love and respect. No anger, no tamasic vyavahar, love and respect for every single person. Do we maintain it in our families? You'll have to see. The family where it is maintained, the family blossoms. Love and respect and service, mutual service, is like giving sprinkler water and nutrition to a plant to blossom. Anger, domination, aggression is like putting a oxyacetylene torch near the roots. It will wilt away. And tell me, how is it possible when we have these days butterfly relationships? You go jump here, there, here. Aaj uske saath, kal kisi aur ke saath. Kya hoga? This is not the way to have forge a family of forged steel. And tomorrow, I used to say it openly in these conferences for masters all, management and all. I said, you cannot be a high-class professional if you have not established a very strong emotional core of your family, which is giving you continuous emotional support and helping you out in moments of stress and problem. Somebody stands by you. I watched the film last night, The Darkest Hour, yesterday evening, with Winston Churchill. I don't know if you have seen it. Superb. And how at the time when Winston Churchill is in two minds, should he go for negotiated peace or stand up for war and victory over Hitler? It is his wife who says, no, you should remain strong and act on your inner instincts and don't give way to people like Lord Halifax and other people telling him, negotiate and save the people in England. He said no. So I'm saying that ultimately this strength comes from the family, that you can count on support. But to do that, you have to build it up. And the way to build it up is to maintain that continuous interaction of love and respect and spirit of service. Can I do something for you that way? So I think if we go on the track of being good Indians, respecting all religions, diversities, faiths, maintaining a strong intellectual streak, reading, learning new things. Today you have so many opportunities to learn through the internet and electronic media also. You have a lovely library down, which I was shown by Dr. Vatsab. Maintain very good family solidarity. Maintain personal honesty to the last penny. And if anybody says, You know, so they say, Kabir Sangat Saad ki jau ki bhusi khaye. Kheer khand bhojan mile saakat sang na jaye. Sangat Saad ki jau ki bhusi khaye. Aur kheer khand bhojan mile saakat sang na jaye. गुरबानी में लिखते हैं साकत सूत बहु गुरजी भरया किनविद तान तनीजे तंत सूत कुछ निकसे नाही साकत संगन कीजे. साकत मीन्स जो बिल्कुल दुनिया में उलझे हुए हैं. फाइन गुड कंपनी एंड ऑल दिस बिजनेस. इफ आई सी आई एम ए पंजाबी पंजाबी फिल्म्स जी वो सारे जट जी बड़ा पींद पी के फिर की होगा. इसी में बड़ी शान है कि हमने इतने वोट का पी लिए. यू आर ऑलरेडी डिस्ट्रॉइंग योर सेल्फ एंड व्हाट आर यू डूइंग फॉर योर फैमिलीज. दी सेल्फ डिस्ट्रक्टिव हैबिट्स शुड बी प्रून फ्रॉम डे वन फिनिश्ड. सेल्फ डिस्ट्रक्शन नाउ दे आर हैविंग ऑल एडवर्टिजमेंट्स ऑन एंटी टोबैको एंड हाउ इट कॉजेज कैंसर एंड ऑल. ड्रिंक्स टू मच एल्कोहल इन द सिस्टम all diabetes, eye problems, you know, kidney problems. What's the point? This human life has been given. Guru Arjan Sahib says, kai janam bhai keet patanga, kai janam gajmeen kuranga, kai janam panchi sarp hoyo, kai janam hai var brikh joyo, mil jagdish milan ki bariya chirang kaal e desh injariya. Badi der ke baad ye manushya nab mila hai. Mil jagdish milan ki bariya. So if we have to go for that kind of communion, then we have to bloody take charge of ourselves from now. And you never know what tomorrow will bring. Guru Nanak Sahib asked his companions, or Rabab Bajande Si, and he said, how far is death? And you know his answer, he said, if a breath is coming in, you are alive. If it doesn't come, you are a mitti di dheri. Let me hope and pray by God's grace and by the inspiration of Swami Vivekanand ji, the great education you are getting from the Vivekanand Institute of Professional Studies, the chairman, the members of the senior faculty, the mentors, all committed people. And I have said also that everyone who comes to this institute must sign a bond of commitment to core values espoused by Swami Vivekananda and maintain it throughout life. And to the extent I have said that the New Delhi Institute of Management, this is Mr. Vishwamohan Bansal's institute, I say anybody throughout the rest of their lives, if they are found to have breached the code of ethical propriety, the diploma should be withdrawn and put into the fire. They don't deserve it. Maybe these are tough words, but as they say, pursuing the straight and narrow path is a tough journey. It is not easy. The easier thing is, oh ji, minister da phone aa gaya to mainu karna pe gaya. Ki karna pe gaya tonu? Final story I'll narrate. When I was in Punjab sometime, somebody said that during the previous government time, they were recruiting sub-inspectors in Amritsar. There was a recruitment. And there was a list of five persons whose names were sent by the Chief Minister's office. Now the requirement was that they must be graduates. So the fellow said, let's include their name. But they sent the degrees, you know, the university degree records to the Guru Nanak Dev University for verification. The registrar said after a few days, all degrees are bogus. So they rang back and said to the Chief Minister's office, unfortunately, they don't fulfill the basic qualification of having the proper graduate degree. What can we do? So I'm told, it's a hearsay, they said, Sanu enal pata nahi ji, tusi kuch kar kara deo, ki kar kara deo. Kar karan naal kuch nahi hunda, because at the end of the day, there is a very hard taskmaster with a very big whip in hand And let me hope and pray, by the grace of Vivekananda ji, by your inspiration, by your sanskars, by what the mentors and teachers are trying to instill in you, you will, each one of you, follow the straight and narrow path, and let people who ask you to breach that narrow path and tilt to the side or leave that track, they said it's a razor's edge. Tell them, you do what you want, I am not going to budge from here. This will be a great tribute to your institute, to our great legacy of Bharat Mata, and let me wish you all the very best and God's blessings. Yeah.